little turd.
All right, all right. We had enough of that last night. Oh, Karen, there's a lawyer here to see you.
Oh, good morning, Stephen Wilson, Mrs. Chambers. Is it all right if I see her alone?
I'll be back shortly.
Please, sit down. Do I make you nervous?
Just wish you wouldn't stare at me, that's all.
I'm sorry.
What do you want to know?
Well, I've read your file, of course. And I'm told there are a number of things missing there. Things you apparently withheld. To begin with, tell me about your husband, Wayne. All right. Let's take it one piece at a time. The day your husband was killed, what were you doing?
I was out.
At work?
Came home. Found my husband in bed with another woman.
Why isn't that in here?
I didn't think it mattered. It was Wayne's best friend's wife.
Name?
Gloria Campbell.
Do you know where she lives?
St. Kilda, Roper Street.
Is this the first time your husband has been unfaithful?
Yes. No. I don't know.
But it was the first time that you had actually...
Yes.
Did you confront them?
I ran downstairs into the kitchen. I had to sit down. I felt sick. Stupid.
Why did you wait until your husband was in the shower before you stabbed him?
I had to get away. I sat down, and it all just welled up inside me. There was a knife.
I see. So, in a fit of anger and jealousy, you killed
your husband. No, I don't. Look, I went through all this at my trial.
Exactly, Mrs. Travers. And if there is ever a retrial, you are going to have to go through the same thing again, and you're going to have to answer the same questions as fully as you are doing now. Did you get on well with your husband?
At first.
Sexual problems?
What's that got to do with it?
Please answer the question, Mrs. Travers.
We had a normal relationship.
I don't believe you. Dr. Miller says that your husband mistreated you. Is that true? In what way?
When he'd been drinking, we'd argue, he'd get violent. Sometimes we wouldn't even fight. He'd just start hitting me out of the blue. He wouldn't stop drinking. He always apologized after it happened. Told me how much he loved me, needed me.
Did anyone else ever see him like this?
No. We lived in a block of flats. The neighbors must have heard us. I don't know.
Good. Good.
Sit down, Meg. I believe you know about Mum's problem with her granddaughter. Jean feels Mum's case ought to be reviewed by the parole board.
They probably won't be too sympathetic, not after the last time she was released.
Oh, yes, but if we let them know why Mrs. Brooks deliberately broke the law and that she didn't intend to keep the stolen articles, it could sway them.
What do you think, Meg?
Well, she's always been a model prisoner. And now that she's got a good reason for staying out of trouble, aren't
they? Yes, if we can convince the board she's reliable enough to look after herself and an expectant granddaughter.
Oh, well, the thing is, last time Mrs. Brooks didn't have anyone to turn to. I mean, she was simply released. It wasn't as if she was on parole. This time, I'd be her parole officer. I could arrange suitable accommodation and make sure she gets some sort of job.
All right. I'll get in touch with the board.
Thank you.
I'd like you to stay a moment, please, Meg. Tell me, were you aware Dr. Miller knew Karen Travers before she was sent here?
Yes, I was, actually. I'm sorry, I just didn't think there was any need to mention it.
Hmm. Well, in future, I'd appreciate it if Dr. Miller and Karen Travers were not left alone together. I'd better speak to her.
Very well.
Well, I'll speak to this Mrs. Campbell, and I'll check around your neighbors.
Does that mean you represent me?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
You know, I'm still puzzled, Mrs. Travers. Why didn't you want any of this brought up at the trial?
I killed my husband, so I felt I deserved whatever I got.
And now you've changed your mind, eh? You don't want to be punished anymore.
I'll have to live with what I've done for the rest of my life, Mr. Wilson.
Is there anything else I should know? Well, I'll be in touch. We'll see what we can do.
All right, Karen?
So peaceful sleeping there. Let's bury the hatchet.
I know where I'd like to bury it.
Oh, look, Bea, we've been mates for years. It seems dumb to spoil all that just because you think I snore.
Think?
All right, I admit it. Maybe I do snore a bit. I make it better?
Oh, what's the use? Over and forgotten.
That's a spirit.
Now, buzz off and let me get some sleep.
I'm not stopping you. And our old Fred was a good sleeper. He could sleep through anything.
Yeah, well, he'd have to be.
That's it?
Nothing.
You know, I reckon that's why I could never hold down a proper job. Not that I minded keeping him. He was good in other ways.
Well, what happened to his job at the warehouse?
Crikey, that was years ago. Your fella out sleeping on the job. You know, I put away me pennies and bought a little shop down in Brighton.
Go on.
It's a good little business, I can tell you.
You own a shop?
Sure, a milk bar. Thought you knew.
And it's in your name?
Of course. I mean, I love Fred, but I wouldn't trust him as far as I could throw him.
Yeah, well, what's happened to it now?
Nothing. Just closed up. I'm not going to let Fred get his hands on it. Teach him a lesson for dobbing me in.
Here, let me give you a hand with those.
Thought you want to sleep.
Yeah, well, after good news like that, who can sleep?
Oh, come on, Frankie. What was wrong with that place? He must have been 100.
Oh, good, Doreen, you just don't think, do you? He said he was living with his daughter.
Yeah, but she wasn't home. And we could have knocked over the place before she got back.
We're sticking to our plan. We're going to find someone who lives by themselves.
I didn't expect this of you, Karen. You're an intelligent woman and you have behaved well since you've been here. However, when it comes to being separated from husbands, boyfriends and general male companionship, I'm very much aware that all women find this one of the most difficult things to adjust to. Dr. Miller tells me you and he were engaged once.
It was a long time ago. You shouldn't blame Dr. Miller. It wasn't his fault.
Yes, well, I'm not concerned with whose fault it is. I'm merely pointing out that should this occur again, I would have no alternative but to replace him.
It won't happen again.
No. Nor will I have you turning to Dr. Miller as a means for setting up a retrial. If you wish to contact anyone in this regard, you'll go through the correct channels. Is that clear?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Come in.
Lynn Warner's been brought in on remand.
Very well. I'll see her tomorrow, I expect. That's all. Will Lynn need to spend any further time in the hospital?
Well, she's had her medical. Apparently she's all right, apart from being a little low.
Well, I think it best if she goes back to work in the garden. She gets on well with Mum. It might help.
Ready, Lynn?
You don't think much of me, do you?
I'm disappointed, that's all. Very, very disappointed.
Well, I knew you would be after you helped me and everything. I even knew you'd look at me like that.
It's a waste, Lynn.
But Doug and I...